Hi, does your linear scale need maintenance? Or want to replace seal rubbers? Or simply want to know how to stretch a silicone rubber strip permanently? Then stick around. A few months ago, I started a digital readout unit project for my milling machine. In previous episodes, I showed how to find connector pinouts for linear scales and how to make a digital readout unit from scratch. If you haven't watched yet, check out my videos. Today, I will cover how I performed maintenance on the linear scales and how I stretched and fitted to the silicone rubber strip. Things could go sideways during the process, so please keep in mind that I'm just sharing my experience. First of all, I removed the aluminum covers on both sides by unscrewing the four screws. Since glass scales are very fragile, I slowly and gently removed the optical reader from its enclosure. Then I put the optical reader in a Ziploc bag to protect it from dust. These linear scales were discontinued 10 years ago, so there is no manufacturer support. Since the seal rubbers on the linear scales are not in good shape, they need to be replaced. Then I removed all seal rubbers with tweezers. First, I cleaned the inner walls of linear scales using isopropyl alcohol and a cotton swab. I tried not to touch the glass scale in the middle because I didn't want to put dirt on it. Then I cleaned the glass scale with a clean cotton swab and IPA. I searched for any possible replacement for seal rubbers, and all I could find was this silicone rubber strip. This wasn't made for my linear scale, but I bought it anyway. Since it doesn't fit into the seal groove, I need to figure it out how to make it thinner. After looking for manufacturing methods for silicone rubber, I found out that extrusion manufacturing is commonly used. What I need to do is heat it up, stretch, and cool it down. Maybe something between those things. To reshape the silicone rubber, I need a heat gun rather than a hair dryer, and I have to be careful not to heat it too much. Because the heat gun is too powerful, I need a setup that won't melt things around or catch fire. I use some aluminium plates to lift the silicone rubber from the table surface, and I use some clamps to fix it to the table. I measure and cut the required length for the linear scale. Since I have to cut off the silicone rubber under the clamps, I made it a little longer. Then I stretched a bit and fixed it using clamps. This is the heat gun that I'm going to use. This is the thickness of the silicone rubber. I heated the silicone rubber by moving the heat gun to the right and left for 2 minutes. Applying a thin layer of silicone lubricant before heating may be better. After 2 minutes, I set the heat gun to cold and set it aside. Then I stretched each side of the silicone rubber. I cool down the silicone rubber by pulling it up with a small screwdriver and moving it left and right. After a minute or so, I measure the thickness of the silicone rubber. After repeating the same heating, stretching, and cooling process, I measured the thickness of the silicone rubber in different places to make sure the thickness was the same in each spot. Then, to know how much it stretched, I measured the length of silicone rubber. Let's replace the seal rubbers. First, I put some lubricant on the seal rubber to make it easier to slide into seal groove. On second thought, silicone lubricant will be better. While straightening up the seal rubber with one hand, I slide into the seal groove using long nose pliers. To not damage the seal rubber, I put some heat shrink tubes on my long nose pliers. Since I couldn't apply enough grip force, I removed one of the heat shrink tubes from the long nose pliers. After sliding the seal rubber, I try to slide closer to the center to release some tension and keep two seal rubbers closer. Since this was my first attempt, even if I had to cut the seal rubber a few times at the ends, it was longer than I needed. So the next time I shortened the length. I stretched one more set for the other side, repeating the same process.
I know, I wish I had used silicone lubricant.
Since I couldn't apply enough grip force, I removed one of the heat shrink tubes from the long nose pliers. Finally, there it is. After sliding the seal rubber, I try to slide closer to the center to release some tension and keep two seal rubbers closer. While doing so, I ripped one end and I had to shorten the length. That's why I left the trimming for last. This is how it looks. During the process, the glass scale may get dirty, so I cleaned it carefully using IPA. Then I put everything together. I slowly and gently slide the optical reader its enclosure. Since the optical reader slides on the top of the glass scale with small bearings, there is only one way to put it in. Then I cut the excess length. Then I put back the side covers on both sides with 4 screws. By the way, since linear scale and silicone rubber material could vary, this may not work for you. So please keep in mind that I'm just sharing my experience. One more thing, some linear scale manufacturers recommend that silicone lubricant be applied to the contact area between the silicone rubber and the detector head once a year. There's a gap between the seal rubbers because when silicone rubber is stretched, it shrinks one side. That's why I can't call this job a perfect success. I think it's better than not having seal rubber at all, but I may have a workaround when mounting them. I actually made 3 pairs of these seal rubbers for the X, Y, and Z axis of my milling machine. In the following videos, I will mount linear scales to my milling machine and talk about the Bluetooth version of PicoDRO. I will also be doing some other videos on other subjects, but this doesn't mean I have abandoned this project. Stay tuned for upcoming videos. If you found this video informative or helpful, please click like. And if you want to see more, please subscribe to help me grow my channel. Let me know what you think in comments. Thanks for watching.